Allora, buon pomeriggio a tutti.
Good afternoon to everybody. We are here to meet the team.
L'equipe del film
of the film
Soul Identity.
The Soul Identity.
Sono presenti al
tavolo. We have gli attori principali. The main actors of this film, starting by the beautiful lady.
Continueremo con il giovane promettente.
Then with the young, Song Yang.
E con grande
and
onore,
with a great honor, Liu Shengli.
All'estremità del tavolo.
At the end of the table, we have the brave producer Li Rei.
E siamo naturalmente felici.
Well, we are happy to have Su Lanfeng.
Allora, adesso sto parlando italiano,
I'm talking Italian, but there is an English translation if you want to listen into English. And we have an interpreter who will translate to everybody. First of all, I'll ask to the director.
Chiederei al regista di ricapitolare.
I want to ask the director to
a tutti qui
tell to everybody
l'intenzione del
the
film,
intention of
storia,
this film. Well, of course, you saw the history.
Capita.
I hope you have understood it, this history, and it is interesting to know.
Sia del cinema,
well, this director used also a novel about martial arts.
Qual è stato il
I would like to know
film
which the project of the film was, not only with for the content, but which kind of form did you want for this film?
Because 就是每一种新的知识体系进来之后，才能形成电影新的这个视觉的形态，所以我的这个知识体系呢，它是这个等于中国民国时候，然后它的这个武馆文化，就是真的是这个武馆文化的这个实战型的武术，就是审美是从这个地方来的。
Ecco, la
penso che le forme derivano sempre dal contenuto, come from the content, dall'insieme
so,
delle informazioni che arrivano. Nel mio caso,
the whole of information in my case, what I wanted
focus,
to focus on are real fights.
Non solo.
Well, not only.
Non solo. Ah, io chiedo, ah.
Not only.
Perché per precisare la domanda, la forma
because
del film è un misto di esattezza.
Just to explain, the whole of the film is a mixture of exact things,
di momenti lirici,
of
di momenti
lyrical moments,
musicali.
Maybe musical moments.
E di momenti divertenti.
Of funny moments.
C'è un personaggio di capo
there is
della, dei
a character,
città,
the chief of the sailors in this city. It is a sort of burlesque character, maybe a grotesque one.
E quindi,
and
il
so
ha
the director had to deconstruct a former universe.
So, well, spiegarlo
could you explain this, including all
location,
choices
di costumi,
about locations,
cast.
Costumes, and casting?
Just 首先讲一下我的这个渊源，哎，就是 因为中国的这个武侠电影呢，是这个，是这个，在首先是来自于这个武侠小说，啊，这武侠小说呢，最初武侠小说发明者呀，他是一个真正的在武馆里边交拳的，一个这个混武馆的人啊，叫平江不孝生，哎，但是呢，这个习武人的这个。 这个文学水平有限，哎，他自己对自己最大的评价呢，就是，啊，我一辈子写小说，但是我文笔不好，哎，然后之后呢，这个武侠小说呢，就是等于被这个，等于是对武术有想象力的文人，哎，他那个占据了这个武侠小说的这个领导地位，啊，然后呢，真正那个习武的人写武侠小说呢，就是。 后继无人，所以呢，这个文人的想象呢，他可能是，都是从哪来的呢？他可能是借用这个中国的戏曲，借用中国的绘画，借用中国书法的审美来的，然后我拍这个呢，是因为我自己呢本身是有这个，武术传承的背景，就是我认识，就是眼光不同，所以呢那个审美会不同。 等于大概是几十年的这个武打片的审美呢，它其实是一个偏舞蹈化啊，然后偏这个MTV 式的啊，就是这样的一个审美。所以呢，大侠一定要在空中，他的身体像蝴蝶一样，他像这个你们西方的这个艺术体操一样，他的四肢一定要撑开，所以他遵循的那个。 美学呢，它是遵循这个美术的这个美学，然后我这部片子的这个审美呢，它是建立在这个武术实战的这个发力的角度，所以呢，你发力，身体就不能腾空，就不能飞来飞去，你必须脚踏实地，才能发出这个力量来，所以呢，这个，所以我的这个速度感呢，它。 它不是那个，这样的就跟以前的武侠电影的那个速度美感，它就产生了距离了，因为它原理不同，然后这个另外一个呢，就是这个是动作形态上，还有一个呢是这个状态上，就是。 可能以前呢处理一个武林的人物呢，就是从这个理想化的角度，就是此人的这个观念、此人的思想跟我们正常人是一样的，他的生活方式也跟咱们正常人一样，唯一的区别就是他会做好事儿，就是这个是这样的。然后我这个片子里呢，就是他是从这个习武人的。 生活状态出发，对他们进行一个描写，你看，比方说呢，就是，真正的习武人呢，其实就跟那个，日本的相扑运动员是一样的，他大部分时间用来睡觉，然后在平时的生活状态里边，并不是，眼光贼亮的精神，因为他的最后搏击那一下呢，他是性命相搏。 所以在平常的时候呢，要把自己的精气神给这个养住，所以平时是能懒则懒，能睡就睡，而且呢，这个你真正习武的话，习到一定阶段，他等于要改变自己全身的气血，所以这时候习武的第一个阶段呢，基本是烂睡，这个一到两个月，就是一天到晚睡觉，这样呢，你的那个身体才能调整过来。 所以呢，这个在我片子里边会出现一些非常懒的，武林人士，然后还有一个就是，但凡就是人如果要求一个技的话，人如果要求一亿，会产生微妙的嫉妒心的，所以这也是那个习武人之间的一个很特殊的人物关系，就是说，你跟我都追求一个东西，但是你的天赋就比我高一点。 你的运气就比我高一点，会有一个微妙的嫉妒心的，所以这个，我呢是希望从这个真实的习武人的心态和他的这个。 生存状态啊、来改变这个武侠片的模式啊。啊啊，对，太强了。
看一下，好吧。OK，ecco。Per quanto
riguarda as far as le fonti, innanzitutto, sources are concerned, first of all, I'm starting with martial arts from a novel style, because in gyms they live, and these novelists lived there. At the beginning, they used those arts, and then they wrote novels. But during time, novelists started to lead the lines of style, but they were not fighters. So how could you express their fantasies? Their fantasy came from pictures, paintings, and literature. But having a strictly linked to Arshan Mars origin, I had a different approach for this style, because this kind of histories used an aesthetics of the dance, where the hero is a sort of butterfly and they express a sort of Western kind of dance, so sort of pictorial aesthetics. I'm starting from true fights, where the style is strictly linked to the traditional style, so my conception is totally different from the past. The aesthetics is different, and this is about theory. But as far as the state of things is concerned, well, first of all, characters had an idealistic dimension, while I start with their daily life, something that is different from other styles, because in daily details I can see a man, a martial art man who resembles to a Japanese sumo man. He must sleep because he must concentrate himself for little moments in which life is equal to the fight. So there is a lot of resting. This is why the fighter has an energy change that during the 2 or 3 months before the fight is just resting. And then a third element is about the little psychological state levels of these fighters that can also consider jealousy, because we cannot have the same objective, but we have jealousy. And so just to conclude, I want to start from the real state, the psychological state of my character, in order to find some other form in this style.
La parola anche a voi.
The word, well, you can talk if you want.
您好，徐导，我想问您一个问题，就是这个《倭寇的踪迹》这部电影之后，您是否还会继续延续这种拍摄这种叫做非主流的武侠电影呢？然后或者是还有其他的打算？然后还有就是在电影中出现了，就是电影中一个细节吧，因为电影中出现了四位比较妖娆的波西米亚女性，然后我想问一下这个元素在电影中有什么特别的含义？谢谢。
Well, I have two questions. The first of all, after the Sword Identity, do you want to do some other films, not from the mainstream? And another question about a particular scene in which there were four little Bosniak women, and could you tell us something about this?
啊，对，就是说是，要在这个领域里边呢，继续探索几部片子，啊，因为这个世界的电影形态很多啊，别的形态呢有人在拍，哎，但是这种呢好像目前只有我在拍，所以我要多拍几部。
About first question, yes, I will do other films. I will make other films because we can use many different forms. And cinema, and, well, I think I'm the only one doing this kind of films in this kind of cinema.
然后包括那个海盗房的这个官员，然后他呢就是现在看着好像是喜剧人物，但是其实呢，在这个古代生活原生态啊，他是有这样的人，就是海盗房的官员呢是以前的官员的势力没那么大，一个县官呢去就任的时候呢，你起码因为当时的那个乡绅阶层的势力是很强的，一个县官去就任。 他起码要在一个地方要拜五个乡绅，就永远不可能是一个官儿，他可以独大的，这是中国以前的那个社会形态，所以我片子里的那海盗房呢就是这样的，然后另外呢写那三个波西米亚女呢，这当然一个呢就是说是这个给这个武侠片呢确立一个新的观看的角度，对吧？就是一个外族的一个异类的一个视角来看这些武林人物的规矩。 异类的一个视角来看这些武林人物的规矩啊，然后还有一个呢，就是，在中国传统社会里边，它专门有一个人群，这个人群就是闲人，啊，就是没事儿人，啊，就是说当大家都在忙着这个事情的时候，然后呢，这个专门有这样的无事人，啊，你看就这个情况一直延续到民国啊，就是说民国的时候，但凡街上永远站着人。
他们是无视人，我就是大概是这样的。Ecco.
Well, as far as the second part of your question is concerned, well, there were characters like these three Bosnian ladies. Well, they were part of the real life of antique times. I didn't want to build comics. Well, for example, in the past, an officer to be respected in his district, he had to use courtesy to other five officers, since there was not a character who had a total power. So from the point of view of three ladies, from a not from the main ethnic, this helps to give an external point of view. And to conclude, well, in antique times in China, there were nothing doing people. They had a precise role, and they had this role until Ming Dynasty. And I wanted to show this in my film.
Io farei ben volentieri una domanda. Scusa.
Oh, yes.
Alzate la mano, però, ragazzi.
我刚才听了导演的阐述，我大概就是以我的理解，就是您的这种写实派的武侠片和原来的那种很写意的、很武侠片来相比的话，您我想问一下导演会不会担心这个观众国内的观众在理解的和接受程度上会比较有难度？然后还想问一下几位演员，就是拍摄这部跟原来比较不同的武侠片有什么感受？谢谢。
Ecco, sentendo proprio
telling, I would like to ask if, well, your point of view is more realistic and it has not a
form of
a spirit of this sword film. Do you think that the medium, well, the average Chinese public could have some difficulties in receiving this kind of film? And another question for everybody, how was it to you to play in another kind of, well, in a new kind of film?
如果没有创意的话，你做任何事情都有难度。这人呢，可以对任何事情感兴趣，所以呢，这个。
Se non c'è creatività,
well, if there is no creativity, if there wasn't be creativity, it would be difficult to end anything you can do. If you have creativity, it is important to be able to lead this process and lead the audience.
问的问题，就是问演员的那个问题，你们对这部片子在拍摄过程中的。
我先讲，谢谢大家。我先讲，我拍过很多，这个从少林寺之后，我拍过很多动作片，但是更多的你会感到它属于武术片，还不是真正的那种侠客片。当然，这里边有一个问题，就是侠的意义，应当学者们去解决的一个问题。但是呢，在这个戏里面。导演他已经有了他的一种侠义的情节，所以他才选择了这样一个题材，这是我的感觉哈，我个人感觉，也许他的感觉可能更加深刻。就是说，你在别的故事里边，你会感觉到这些人在深山老林里面如何生活，如何生存，穿着现代人穿着古装的衣服，飞来飞去的感觉武艺非常高，但是走路都走不成个，你就觉得那。太脱离真实了，如果从真实入手又太难拍，因为你不是古人那种没受过古人那种训练，没有生活在那样一个文化环境里面，所以说就简直没办法去演这个人。那么导演现在他这种故事呢，你没有对武学的体验，你压根你身上就没有感觉，就是我们可以听，我们可以看很多东西，你可以积累起来，但是你身上的感觉不到的话，你演起来也会特别吃力。所以那么我接到这个故事以后呢，首先我的观念就是说，电影永远是导演的艺术，尽管它是个综合艺术，但是呢它要做总工程师这个角色。因此呢，我对剧本的把握就是说，这个人物的历史背景和他的文化背景是什么，他的行为逻辑我就能容易把握住。那么他描写的是一个武士出身的一个武侠，就我演的是邱冬月嘛。那么很多东西我从练功的过程当中，你可以体会到，就是身体所能体会到的体育的那一部分。然后呢，你通过思想的那种思考，你会感受到，就是他文化深层结构的一部分。因此你演起来的时候呢，就我就觉得只能去把握这些东西，最后呢还要靠全体，靠导演去把握你行不行。谢谢。
Ecco
io dopo i film su
after
Shaolin,
films about Shaolin
action,
that was an action film
spada, ushu,
well,
diciamo,
Let's say that we like to researchers with the issue to understand what we are thinking about heroes. But the author knows what the kind of author he wants to express. And other films I did, well, I wondered how these characters can live flying with modern means, but they cannot.Walk dressed like that in the real life. Starting from a more realistic point of view, it was difficult for us to play our roles because you cannot train as once did.They did. So, of course, our director has a longer experience and, well, we trust on him. But personally, I saw him as a general, as an engineer who helped me to understand the historical situation of the character and also the context of the telling. In Chudumia, my character had a sport, a kung fu,task to learn, and then a part made of thoughts and culture, and I asked the director to help me, and so it was a teamwork with a full trust on each other.
I 是一个武侠迷，而且我有很浓重的武侠情节，但是之前我也拍摄过很多参与拍摄的武侠的电视剧或者电影， 曾经那个时候我也陶醉于自己吊着威亚满天飞的那种，觉得是很飘逸，此刻我是个侠。但是这回这一部电影拍完之后，我感觉我对侠有了一个新的认识，包括动作方面，从花哨的东西变成真实的，就是完全还原真实的武技那种格斗机技。对我来说，我觉得包括我以后要走的路可能会有一个比较大的影响，而且我会有一个新的方向。很吸引我。我觉得如果有机会，我会继续走下去，真实的武侠世界这条路我会继续走下去。谢谢。
Ecco, per me, che sono stato un fan,
I think, well, I was a fan of this kind of films. I had other experience taking part to fictions and films in which this kind of sword film was realized. And I wanted to fly as all the other heroes fly. And then letting a part of this, all the details from this kind of telling and using this more realistic way of filming, I found myself in a new direction that I like a lot, so I would like to go on this new style.
Hello. 我呢是第一次拍武侠片，然后以前呢对于武术呢也就是对武术的一些了解都是从电影上，就像刚刚他们说的那样，那种很炫啊，然后吊威亚或者有特技啊那种的，是那样的认识。但是呢我拍了倭寇以后呢，就觉得有一种新的认识。但是我只能说，就是我印象最深的一些，就是拍摄当中的一些感受，就比如说有一些道具啊什么的，就是导演坚持一定就是要用真的，但是那些东西都会是很重的那样，然后拍的时候呢就会可能做动作啊什么的就会很困难，但是真的拍出来了以后就是效果不一样，就感觉很真实。对，谢谢。
Salve a tutti.
Per me è stata una prima volta.
For me it was the first time. It was the first time in which I played in this kind of film. But I looked many special effect film. In the Sword Identity, I understood. Well, I had a new impression about this kind of film. I can tell that during the filming, the scene objects and arms were true. So they were heavy, and, but using this method, the effect was wonderful. So we know that the director studied cinema, and he's still a teacher of cinema at the National Beijing National Cinema School. And so, thinking about this part of biography, I would like to know if, well, apart his truthful from his martial art part of his life, if, well, do you have some shufu in the history of your cinema?
Just 然后就是这个传统呢，它其实是它是那个苏联移植过来的一个传统然后呢等于是苏联文化跟那个中国文化的一个结合然后我呢是非常受益于这个电影的传承，但是呢也受苦于这个传承因为呢那个你看像塔尔科夫斯基，他学电影大学时代他要学8年电影，然后塔尔科夫斯基自己写的书觉得实在受不了了这个干嘛要学这么长时间但是呢其实呢这个你学一个手艺是非常快的然后但是呢你要学一个审美的锤炼就得需要好长时间那让我受苦是什么呢，就是当时觉得一毕业之后自己呢除了能够砍电影之外，就是能够 评论电影之外，自己一无所长，就是说这个怎么活下去，然后呢，但是呢，等于经过这个毕业啊十多年之后，你其实发现很多东西呢，这个你不用学，或者你很短的时间你就可以会了，小说、话剧都是我自己会的，也没人教我，然后剪接也是这个非线性剪接啊，在那儿一指导也就知道怎么回事儿，也就会了，但是最难的就是说能够让我这个胜出的就是说我跟一些这个也是热爱电影的人，但是我觉得我的创造力或者在某一方面的创造力，我能够有我自己的特色这个其实是受益于我那个四年的这个审美的这个训练对，所以现在的一些小孩呢，就是其实也为他们，因为这个社会竞争日益剧烈嘛，所以呢，这个上学的时候要多学很多手艺，这样你出去之后能生存。就是再像我们这一代这样的能从容的学电影，就是现在的小孩可能被压迫的没有这种没有这个幸福了吧。
Beh, sono stati sicuramente i maestri
okay,
del Dipartimento Regia nella Accademia Cinematografica di Pechino, uno stile russo, una cultura sino-russa,
in Beijing,
perché,
who
sì,
taught me
Chinese
and Russian techniques. I found it easier to tell about this technique. Tarkovsky said he had been studying 7 years long, but it wasn't enough. So we have to think about her aesthetics, and crafts has two different things. So we have to find something inside us, and after 5 years I could talk about cinema, but I couldn't use it in a concrete way and survive, and this was my problem. But then the awareness of the after tells me that in the successive 10 years, well, that period was really important to me, because sometimes we don't need a concrete study, but you are able to learn on the short term. Otherwise, you can learn something practicing things, for example, in theater or in editing. And this was my history. It was different from other filmmakers, because finding my own aesthetics, it was more difficult. Today in China, many young people studying in China are crushed by competitiveness, and so they have to learn manual work. Our generation was more free. So we want to thank our guests, actors and directors and director and producer. Now I think that everybody will go on asking questions to you. So well, compliments, really compliments.